Hello, I'm Victor Coutard. I'm working for Les Pépinières Européennes pour Jeunes Artistes, which is a European art organization who help artistic mobility in Europe and at the international.
مرحبا انا كريستال خوري بحسي بعالم الرقص جاي من لبنان من بيروت وبتعامل كمان مع روبرتو فوند شيميتا.
السلام عليكم. بدر حمدان الحارثي من سلطنة عمان، عضو في الشبكة الدولية لتثقيف الأقران التابعة لصندوق الأمم المتحدة للسكان. دورنا في برامج التوعية والإرشاد.
خديجة بليز. We're gonna follow.
Okay, we started our working group discussing the proposition that made by the organizers, and we made general remarks. We said that artists and arts and art in general should be in the heart of the process, because we noticed that the voice of artists is missing. And the second general remark, we stressed that it's very important to build capacities of artists and cultural practitioners to get familiarized with the white papers, advocacy tools, and the use of a common language that is understood by the stakeholders. We chose to work on one activity because we didn't have time, and also we needed to discuss a lot amongst us. So we decided to start with the activity research on social and economic impacts of mobility and creative economy, because we believe that it will feed the white papers. And we had a discussion amongst us if we have to make this research on a national or a regional level. Then we agreed that it should be done on a national level. I hope that all my colleagues agree on that. And we started to list the tasks that should be implemented, that should be carried to implement the research. We said that first we have to define term of references of the research. Second, to hire a researcher. We had also a discussion about hiring a researcher. So we were wondering if the researcher has to be a national, a local-based researcher, knowing the lack of expertise on the field on that matter in the Arab world. We were also wondering if the researcher has to be someone coming from the cultural sector or from another sector. We didn't take a decision about the profile of the researcher. Then the second task was the carrying the research, then presenting the first draft of the research and finalizing the report. In terms of time frame, we had a lot of discussion about it, if it should take 1 year to carry this research. So we agreed on that 1 year, but meanwhile, carrying the research, we discussed to organize what Rami called quick wins. So we said that while defining the term of references of research, we have to involve stakeholders in the research process. We have to create a website about creative economy and to make media campaign and present the first draft of the research during a creative economy conference, for example. That's what we decided so far, and please, my colleagues, if you disagree with me, don't hesitate, or if you have any comments, please. Thank you.
Did you understand? Do you have any comments, any suggestion? I only need to understand, Khadija, أو لازم نفهم موضوع الارتست وكيف إنه مش موجود. يعني مش كتير فهمت in the heart and خصوصا بهاي الدوكيمنت كيف هلا ايش بدكم نحط بهاي الدوكيمنت هلا الاشي المهم اللي حسيتوه مش موجود اول نقطه
we had this comment because Christina, I'm sorry. Christina said that she had like a trouble. She was asking for more details about the link between art and the economy. So you came to explain us what we all agree that art is useful for economy because it creates a job, because it gives like highlighting to some cities because of many reasons.
Any comment? أي تعليق? Do you have any other issue on? No. Thank you, Group One. وخديجة I noticed إنه كتبتي ف if you can send it to us it will be very helpful okay group two please two finance
we were speaking in French and we were representing more of the countries from the Maghreb so I'll put my give you the microphone to the other people
French.
D'accord. Alors, D'accord. Je suis Wefe Gebsi, je suis tunisienne, mais je suis basée à Paris, chercheure à l'Université Paris 1 et jeune commissaire. Voilà.
Je suis Moufida Fidila, artiste, enfin plasticienne et cinéaste. Je suis entre Paris et Tunis et boursière du Fonds Roberto Chimetta.
Omar Iznain du Maghreb, cinéaste et aussi fondateur d'une petite association artistique qui s'appelle Aza Art au Maroc. Merci.
Malem Aoubouk, Mauritanien, member of Stikshav Mauritanie.
Alors, on a un petit souci dans notre groupe, parce qu'on a beaucoup parlé, et c'était très très intéressant, de tous les problèmes liés au financement de la mobilité, mais on a besoin de votre aide pour définir justement un action plan un peu plus soutenu, parce qu'on n'a pas eu le temps vraiment de travailler là-dessus. Donc, on a décidé aussi qu'on allait partager la parole. Je pense que je vais donner tout de suite le micro à Wafa, qui va peut-être présenter ce qu'elle a retenu de cet atelier, et puis Moufida, et puis les autres, si vous voulez. Et puis après, on aimerait bien vos questions et puis voir comment on peut justement bâtir un action plan là-dessus.
On a essentiellement focalisé notre discussion sur les difficultés rencontrées par les artistes au niveau local. Me concernant, je vais parler un peu de mon expérience parce que j'ai eu affaire à faire une enquête en Tunisie pendant un an et demi avec les artistes, ce qui m'a permis de comprendre. D'accord. Ok. Ce qui m'a permis de comprendre qu'il y a quatre grands problèmes en Tunisie liés que les artistes mentionnent à chaque fois. Donc la première chose, c'est la visibilité à l'échelle internationale et nationale aussi. Le manque de networking et la connexion, tout ce qui se rapporte au réseau avec les institutions locales et aussi internationales. Le problème de financement, c'est un gros chapitre par rapport aux actions, au manque d'action du ministère de la Culture et du gouvernement tunisien. Et là, ce grand chapitre, on en a un peu discuté. Et en fin de compte, l'éducation de l'art contemporain au niveau national. Donc pour ce qui est le chapitre de financement, c'est vrai que au niveau du Maghreb, j'ai une petite idée parce que j'en ai fait des recherches, mais particulièrement en Tunisie, le problème c'est que Et surtout actuellement, le gouvernement n'a pas vraiment alloué de budget pour les arts plastiques et les arts visuels, vu qu'il y a une dominance ou une primauté d'autres secteurs comme le secteur économique, militaire et peut-être aussi médical. Donc c'est vrai que le budget pour les arts et tout, c'est quelque chose, c'est un sujet assez sensible vu ce qui s'est passé avec la révolution et les problèmes de censure. Donc ça reste toujours un débat qui est de longues haleines et qu'il faut vraiment combattre pour discuter sur ça. Donc ce qu'on a discuté, on s'est dit que peut-être une action serait efficace d'engager une discussion avec le ministère et le gouvernement, et peut-être un fonds comme Roberto Chimietta peut vraiment venir avec un dossier avec une certaine légitimité et crédibilité pour discuter avec l'État et le ministère pour que ça soit vraiment efficace et à long terme quelque chose qu'on va en travailler là-dessus pour avoir des financements pour les artistes et les opérateurs. Voilà.
Wow. Bon, je crois que tu as fait presque le tour. Mais... Ok. Oui. Alors, en fait, on a parlé de quelque chose d'urgent, enfin, deux choses d'urgent. D'abord, le réseau sud-sud. C'est-à-dire que dans les pays arabes, généralement, il y a une sorte d'effritement où on n'arrive pas forcément à se focaliser sur une énergie interne pour pouvoir parler de mobilité ou de créer des échanges et de coopération. Donc comment développer ce projet en connexion avec le Nord? Donc c'est ce que tu as fait allusion par rapport à des rencontres ou autre chose. Et puis le financement urgent. Donc est-ce qu'il faut attendre réellement le gouvernement pour qu'il réagisse et que c'est lui qui prenne l'initiative pour changer sa manière de financer, ou plutôt aussi faire dans l'autre sens le pousser à le faire? Donc il faut que ça se passe dans des deux sens. Donc qu'est-ce qui aujourd'hui en financement urgent, comment on s'est posé la question, comment ça peut prendre forme avec un travail sur le long terme en engageant des entreprises qui seront intéressées, ou de faire un travail avec le gouvernement?
Do you have any, when you read the, sorry, when you read the agenda, did you think it's clear, comprehensive? Do we need to add anything that is missing? Did it cover all the problems that you talked about?
Well, yes, I mean, it is clear, and that's not a difficulty, and I think it's a lot of what is said is very good, very well said. But what we felt in our discussion was that it was interesting to start again from the ground, and, you know, so that everybody can say what they think about funding for mobility, the difficulties. I think it's important to keep going back to that. Even if we do, we have made some recommendations and we're going to work on them, because it's always difficult to say we want the government to do this, we want the municipalities to do that. We have to start from where we are and see what we can do, what the difficulties are. Maybe there are things that we've missed along the way that we can just, you know, like this idea of local networking. We were talking a lot about local development. For example, Omar mentioned BMW that has, for the first time, I think, talked about including in its own kind of propaganda this question of mobility and using the arts. Of course, there's a lot to say about that, and we don't necessarily want to go there, but because it works on a local level, and because you're talking about selling cars to local people, there could be something there that is maybe interesting as far as funding goes. But that needs to be worked on. So we were just really trying to look at different options, the way we did in Alexandria, and I really liked it, where we were talking a lot about the companies and how actually companies don't necessarily consider mobility as something that is worthwhile. They think it's a waste of time. So how can you change that kind of mentality? And maybe there's little pocket funding there that could help out. So rather than always focusing on the government, even if I agree with Wafa, that's something that we can start doing now. And I think that the Istikshaf platform is a good way to do it, because we are stronger. We're not just one organization, we are several. And if we go to them with good arguments and something that is that has come about through different meetings, and we have a policy document and all of this, then yes, we will be able maybe to get our voice heard a little more. And I agree with the fact that artists have to be involved, but I think there are some here. So I don't think that's a problem today as much as maybe it could be elsewhere. And there was other things that came across, like the fact that when there is funding of mobility, but because of the language barrier and because people don't know necessarily how to fill in the forms correctly, then there's a kind of a lack of, and also lack of information, so that people don't know where they can get this funding. Those aren't necessarily policy recommendations, but they're part of a process that also has to be worked on somewhere along the line. Maybe we can do it amongst ourselves, but if we do, we have to find someone somewhere to bring all of that together. Again, maybe it's the Istikshaf platform, but if people do their little research on their own and then it all falls apart, then you know the urgency matter, the time frame won't be there. So somebody has to capitalize on the energies.
This should be the first action item. Okay. Work on the information.
Yeah. Yeah, it could be the first action. So I don't know if anybody has any comments that could help us structure an action plan.
أي حدا عنده أي تعليق على موضوع التمويل من الجمع من المؤسسة يعني الجروبس الثانية أو المجموعات الثانية. Going once. طيب. طيب. We'll because we only have half an hour. Group three. Hello. Please introduce yourself and then.
هديل نظمي بشتغل مع روبرت تشميتا كإكسبرت دايركتنج اند فيلم ميكينج وفي الجروب
لوسيان أرينو I am the director of a dance center in Alexandria. I'm French but based in Egypt for the past 7 years. Seven. yeah, so it's an independent cultural center which is promoting and trying to develop dance activities in Alexandria, Egypt.
أنا فادي بشير بشتغل مع منظمة دولية للشباب عفوا وبعمان عم بتطوع مع الملتقى كمنسق سفر المحلي.
Zeynep Akdure, I'm an architect. I teach urban and architectural history, theory, and conservation. I was the secretary general of SanArt Association for the promotion of visual arts back in Turkey, and board member of Architects Association, which is the oldest for architects in Turkey. Both may be open for participation in this platform. And I was recently a grantee of Roberto Cimenta Foundation.
I will try to synthesize. Well, basically, we didn't have that much time also, so in the end we end up with a kind of superficial work plan and which is rather incomplete. However, we started first of all to exchange some experiences and try to think about this issue of visa and obstacles to mobility related to the legal framework in different countries. And basically, it's a very big issue, which is limiting mobility nowadays. And well, we went through the proposals, which to us, I hope, I mean, I say it right. I mean, to us the paper seems to cover all the areas which are important to this topic. However, some little points could also be expanded. For example, the first recommendation. My colleague Zeynep mentioned the case of Turkey and some Arab-speaking communities in Turkey, which have real problems to travel as well. And so maybe we could expand the scope and not only limit the study to the Arab world. Afterwards, when it comes to the to other points, it's quite general and quite clear. Now we try to draw a little work plan, but however we didn't have enough time to cover all the areas covered in this paper. So basically we started with what is really important is to have a clear idea about the situation. So Angie this morning mentioned the survey, which was done through the Cimeta Fund. However, we think this survey could be expanded as well to other organizations, other mobility operators. So, but first of all, we also would like to have a proper research done at the legal level among ministries of interiors, foreign affairs, consulates, to be able to know the actual situation in all the different countries involved. And that would take a little bit of time because in some cases it might be easy to collect the information, but not in all the cases. So the question was who would be able to do that? Is it one person, or do we have to ask one person in each country to try to collect the information, and from we have to identify from which official bodies we have to collect the information? Is it the Ministry of Interior, the Foreign Affairs? Do we have to contact the embassies in the different countries, etc., etc.? So it's a long process. So we very ambitiously put the date of June 2013 for the Arab region, and then December 2013 for EU and Mediterranean countries. And we were even thinking of expanding the study to like other countries around, which might be also relevant, I mean, on the African continent and also other continents. However, this is a very, very long and complicated task. After this research, we discussed also the question of the survey. So first of all, we would need to prepare a comprehensive survey, but however, this has been done by the Cimeta Fund, but also to contact other mobility operators in order to expand the survey to other organizations, to other people. And then we would have to organize the survey, analyze the results. And what would be interesting also would be to compare the results of the survey with what we collected during the research, to compare the theory and the practice, because we think that in some cases it should be linked, and there might be some surprises because Obviously, if we collect information from official bodies, they will say this, this, this has to be done. But then in practice, we might discover that in many cases, it was very different. And it could actually, I mean, it would be worth of interest to have these two in comparisons. For the rest of the topic, we went really, really superficially through the points, so I don't know if it's really worth mentioning, because afterwards we had, however, a little question concerning the strategy, the second point, this white paper on low risk, high risk visa system, security system. It posed a little problem to us because we didn't really understand what this meant. High risk, low risk, about what is it on the at the state level, the security policies for the states, or is it high risk, low risk to obtain a visa at the artist or cultural operator level when someone applies to a visa? So what does this really mean? Apart from that, yes, the fourth point, the regional national campaigns. Yes, it is important to influence the public opinion, but there should be some lobbying work, obviously done on decision makers. But I suppose this is related with. I mean, both are related.
Related. But I have a question, Hada. What can we do as I ask the other groups, as a quick win? What can we do within the coming 6 months to try to at least talk about the visa issue in the region? Yani, we need to do something because the research will minimum take 6 months or a year. But what can we do to initiate this and pressure the governments to talk about this in the social media, in the papers, through a conference? What do you suggest?
Yeah, of course, many things can be suggested, but it is difficult to start campaigning if you don't have all the elements in hand, and the research and the survey are fundamental in the beginning, because you need to know where to stand if you want to lobby, if you want to campaign. You cannot talk through your hat and say this and this based on what you heard. It really has to be based on actual research and survey. So this is the first step which has to be started, but obviously it's a long process, and it wouldn't be realistic to to imagine that this could take less than a year, and then afterwards, because, for example, in the EU nowadays, this is something we talked about also a little bit, this question of debate about immigration, for example, but then how to separate the issues, immigration and mobility for a project, because these issues are completely different. But the problem is that mobility suffers from the fact that it's mixed up with the immigration policies. But this, again, is something which needs to be based on an actual survey and research at the official level.
Okay.
So actually, we were thinking that this 14th, number 14, it's a bit open-ended about what debates and the conferences about what. We thought that maybe that would clarify after this survey and the research. Maybe in, let's say, in EU countries, the main focus of the conferences and debates should be on this difference between immigration and mobility, whereas in others, maybe state control can be the main issue. So there may be a variety in the topics of debate depending on the regions. And also I think these embassies and consulates can be added to the stakeholders.
It's our central government. But we need to
practices.
I thought, yeah, sure. Any other note from the other groups? Visa. Ah, you are the visa.
I just wanted to ask you, when you were talking about the legal level, you meant everything that we could use to defend the reason why artists should travel? So using international treaties where it's mentioned that artists should be free of movement and things like that? Is that what you mean? And that we could then say to the states that have signed these agreements, yes, but you're not putting your agreement that you signed into practice because you're stopping the mobility of artists?
That's a very interesting question.
To be totally honest, we didn't go that far. No, basically, what we were thinking about was the framework, the actual framework of how to apply what each state, how does each state organize the system for visa application? Do they have specific criteria for artists, specific systems, or not? In order to compare this with the actual experiences of the people in reality, and then to say when something has to be asked from the governments to say, okay, this is actually the situation, but yes, indeed, to compare this with the treaties would be even more interesting to see the... I mean, there's like three levels.
Can I help? All right. I think this is an excellent question and recommendation. And as I said, for the quick win, in my opinion and recommendation, I think a quick benchmarking study to compare the regulatory system against the UN treaties in the Arab countries and in the EU maybe, or I don't know, is the quick win, because it's easily done. We can do it in a couple of months. We can show that these laws and regulations are in conflict one way or another with the UN treaties. And then we can go to the technical legal review of every law and every regulation. And of course, as we said in the morning, we want to be proactive. So we might suggest a system for them. And high level, of course, not detail. And this is what I don't want to go into details of low, high risk, low risk system, because it's a technical issue. But in a nutshell, it's something that lawyers and governments apply to simplify the process. So you will have a low-risk countries and the high-risk countries. You have certain criterias or different criterias to manage the applications. So if you have and now they apply it, of course. So if you have someone coming from a war zone, it's a completely different process than someone coming from a different zone. But in the Arab world, we don't have this low-risk, high-risk system. They treat everybody like coming from anywhere. It's all about the judgment of the counselor or the embassy or the person sitting in the Ministry of Interior. So, Anna, I think we need to create this system for them, or suggest the concept of high-risk, low-risk. Please.
أنا بس عايزة أشارك تجربة حصلت لي في هولندا وليها علاقة بالهاي ريسك اند لو ريسك لو أنا فهمت كلامك صح. إن أنا وأنا داخلة البلد وأنا خارجة من الطيارة لقيت في بوليس واقف ماسك ورق في إيده بيبص على كل حد هو خارج يبص في الباسبور يعدي فجي بس في الباسبور بتاعي قفل الورق وأخدني في إيده ومشي. And they kept me في أوضة مقفولة معرفش إيه اللي حاصل مش ما بيشرحوا ليش. To cut a long story short, في الآخر اكتشفت إن أنا high suspect for drug dealing because I'm Arab, I'm Muslim, I'm young, and my ticket is paid by Swiss, Dutch organization SICA. مش مهم معاهم هي ايه الorganization اللي بعتالي, المهم ان انا تذكرتي مدفوعة من جوه البلد وان انا عربية مسلمة صغيرة في السن. Then I'm a high suspect of drug dealing. Yes, high risk. فطبعا كان يعني حاجة محرجة ومحزنة, بس ابسو فاكتو ده الموقف اللي حصل معي السنة الفاتت. ده طبعا
should send this to Angie, please. Type. Any other comment on the visa issue? Because it's the most, يعني, لا, sorry, we can.
Because that was in the beginning of the discussion, and then we started talking about the work plan. Basically, Hadil was mentioning what we call the medical tourism, and the fact that there are some organizations which are meant to facilitate people to travel for medical issues. And why, in the short term, because the legal system is complicated for mobility, why at least wouldn't there be some NGOs at the local level to help individuals in these procedures, to inform them, maybe to help them to fill in forms, because sometimes it is complicated if you don't know exactly what to put in the form, to basically provide some assistance for people to travel at the visa level, because so far there. No, it was based on this example because it works now for medical issues. So why for artists, for example, wouldn't there be, because I didn't make it clear, why wouldn't there be the same kind of organizations but NGOs, so non-for-profit, which would be there at the local level to help and to assist people in these procedures, because if you're on your own and if you don't know who to ask, how to fill in an application, it can be really complicated to actually proceed.
Thank you. And I'm assuming that's the role of the mobility operators, or they should took that role. But we can add it as a tool that they need to include it in their programs of work or strategies to concentrate on facilitating visa. And it is also linked to the information. And now all NGOs, mobility operators, should work to provide information about mobility, visa issues. All right. Any other?
Je me demandais si c'est faisable, par exemple, de créer dans les ambassades, ça veut dire dans les organismes qui donnent les visas, c'est les ambassades, les consulats, donc, une coopération entre un agent du département culturel, de la mission culturelle, avec l'entité qui délivre les visas. Donc un artiste qui veut, par exemple, libanais, qui a une résidence d'artiste à faire en France ou bien une expo, vu que à l'ambassade de France, la mission culturelle est intéressée à encourager les échanges entre artistes de plusieurs pays, des deux pays. Donc au lieu que ce ne soit l'entité qui s'occupe généralement des visas vers qui l'artiste va aller directement, l'artiste ira présenter par exemple un visa spécial artiste, il explique à l'agent de la mission culturelle qu'est-ce qu'il essaie de faire au juste, comme ça c'est facilité de manière interne, donc le processus d'obtenir le visa est facilité entre des agents à la mission culturelle, à l'ambassade, comme un intermédiaire pour faciliter, avec éventuellement un formulaire de demande de visa spécial artiste, par exemple.
Thank you.
Sorry.
Oui, juste pour dire que ce système existe déjà. Hein. C'est-à-dire que les artistes alors, qui sont en contact avec l'Institut français, par exemple à Beyrouth ou dans tout autre pays, ou qui font la démarche d'entrer en contact à partir du moment où ils ont besoin d'un visa, sont évidemment recommandés auprès du consulat par l'Institut français, par l'attaché culturel. Voilà. Donc ce système existe déjà. La difficulté qu'on peut avoir sur les visas dans un pays comme la France, c'est que ce n'est pas le consulat qui prend la décision de délivrer un visa. Ce n'est même pas le ministère des Affaires étrangères, c'est le ministère de l'Intérieur. Et on se heurte en France, comme en Europe, comme dans un certain nombre de pays, à une contradiction difficile à résoudre, même si on essaye de la résoudre. Et cette contradiction, c'est à la fois une demande de la population, des citoyens, de limiter l'immigration, et en même temps une volonté aussi d'ouvrir la porte, bien entendu, à la venue d'étrangers. C'est cette contradiction qui est difficile à résoudre. C'est à cause de ça que c'est le ministère de l'Intérieur qui est en charge de la délivrance de l'accord sur le visa. Et voilà, c'est là-dessus qu'on bute. Mais on travaille aussi, il y a des groupes de travail en ce moment pour essayer d'améliorer les choses, et notamment peut-être d'arriver à quelque chose qui pourrait être, en ce qui concerne les artistes, un visa artiste.
Bonjour, je suis Inès Da Silva, je travaille au ministère de la Culture, donc on est les deux représentants de Paris, là, de l'État. Et effectivement, en complément de ce que vient de dire Julien, quand on arrive à résoudre des problèmes pour les visas d'artistes, on arrive à en résoudre beaucoup entre nos deux équipes. Il y a des gens qui font ça plusieurs fois par semaine, de résoudre des problèmes en cas d'urgence. Mais d'une façon générale, le ministère de la Culture anime un groupe de travail avec plusieurs autres ministères, travail, etc., etc., pour faciliter pour les professionnels français la venue d'artistes étrangers. Parce que, y compris les professionnels... Enfin, je comprends que quand on est dans un pays du sud ou de l'est de la Méditerranée, on comprenne rien à comment il faut faire pour obtenir tous les papiers nécessaires pour rentrer en France. Et effectivement, vous n'êtes pas seul, puisque nous, on répond toute la journée à des gens qui sont en France, des fois dans des grandes institutions, et qui n'y arrivent plus à savoir dans quel sens il faut faire les choses pour arriver à inviter un artiste de l'étranger. Et c'est pas seulement cette zone géographique là qui pose problème, hein. Il y a beaucoup d'autres pays, y compris nous, on est saisis sur des Américains qui arrivent pas à rentrer, nous on a aussi des problèmes de Français qui arrivent pas à rentrer aux États-Unis. Enfin voilà, la chose que sur laquelle moi je voulais réagir, c'est que effectivement, dans les postes diplomatiques, il faut qu'il y ait une coopération entre le service culturel et le consulat. La question du visa spécial pour les artistes, elle est évoquée en ce moment par nos deux ministres, notamment, mais Julien a raison de répéter et de dire que c'est le ministère de l'Intérieur qui décide, parfois seul, et on essaye de pas le laisser décider seul, mais en tout cas ils sont souverains là-dessus, de qui rentre et qui ne rentre pas sur le territoire français. Donc nous, on passe notre temps à expliquer que les artistes, ils ont pas toujours une fois et demie le SMIC français, parce qu'ils ont des contrats courts, ils ont des revenus divers. Il n'y a pas de statut d'artiste dans beaucoup de pays dans le monde, mais que ce n'est pas parce qu'ils sont serveurs dans un restaurant, en plus d'être artistes, qui ne sont pas vraiment artistes. Voilà, donc ça c'est notre travail constant. Et la façon dont effectivement ça peut être arrangé, c'est, ça passe par le niveau local, donc dans chaque ambassade, dans chaque consulat, qui est une meilleure coopération. Notre président français a fait un voyage en Afrique assez récemment pour le sommet de la francophonie, et il a évoqué cette question-là, cette question de faciliter pour un certain nombre de professions qui sont très mobiles, donc il y a les artistes, il y a les chercheurs et les scientifiques, voilà, pour les laisser circuler entre le sud et le nord et entre le sud et le sud. Donc voilà, on travaille beaucoup là-dessus, et c'était un peu la question que moi je voulais dire, qu'on travaille au niveau national beaucoup là-dessus. Et au niveau européen, je sais qu'il y a eu une réunion la semaine dernière à Bruxelles et que l'Union européenne est très mobilisée sur ces sujets. Quelqu'un de mon équipe y était, sauf que j'attire votre attention sur le fait que le niveau européen peut donner toutes les recommandations qu'il veut et essayer de faire que les États membres travaillent mieux sur ces questions-là, sauf que les États membres de l'Union européenne diront et continueront à dire que ça, c'est une compétence strictement nationale. Nous, on a essayé d'agiter les recommandations de l'Union européenne sous le nez du ministère de l'Intérieur. Ils nous ont juste répondu que c'était pas beaucoup nos affaires, nous au ministère de la Culture, nous le ministère des saltimbanques, comme ils disent, mais que c'était surtout pas l'affaire de l'Union européenne de leur dire ce qu'ils avaient à faire. Voilà, donc j'attire votre attention là-dessus, c'est-à-dire que c'est bien que l'Union européenne soit mobilisée, mais c'est avant tout une compétence de chaque État, et des États du Sud et de l'Est de la Méditerranée aussi, de régler cette question-là. Parce que l'Union européenne peut faire toutes les recommandations qu'ils veulent, et c'est comme s'ils pissaient dans un violon, comme on dit en France, en argot. Voilà.
Thank you. Thank you for the comments. I think we totally understand, and we might ask for your help later through Angie to maybe study your processes and try to work with our ministries, because actually we don't have systems. In Arab countries, most laws and regulations were developed back in the 60s, when after the independence of, and we did not yet work to update. So hopefully this can be the platform to start in the Arab world, and then if we need to go outside. No, we don't have time. Khalinan.
Yeah. As you say, how Arab countries are still very far from this. Up until last year, a woman in Lebanon was not could not travel if she did not have the authorization of her husband.
In Jordan also, it's the same. Actually, this is something that we need to add to the agenda, because this is very important. Group 4 سوري بس راح يعني بسرعة عشان نلحق الفريق من الأول فكرت هيك
السلام عليكم سيف الشرجي سلطنة عمان منسق برنامج سفر محلي
I'm Yarnaya Barnak. I'm the International Program Coordinator of Maribor 2012, European Capital of Culture. In 2008, I was coordinating the online arts festival of the EMIAN EuroMed Young Artists Network. The network is now non-existing, but I'm trying to work on that further for a network of new media artists in this region.
Ahmed Elyasri, from Iraq, فريق عمل سفر في العراق.
عبير سليمان من مصر. Drug dealer. I'm a storyteller and a writer, And recently, with a group of artists, we established an NGO in Egypt called Noon, الوكالة العربية للتبادل الثقافي, to work as art agency in the Arab world and the Middle East.
نسمة جويري من مصر, منسقة صندوق سفر بمصر.
صفاء يعقوب الطيب من السودان, منسقة صندوق سفر في السودان.
طيب احنا كان الجروب بتاعنا بالاساس بيتكلم على ضمان المشاركة المجتمعية في فكرة تجوال الشباب او يعني تجوال الافراد عموما ونشر ثقافة السفر, وكان من اهم التحديات اللي كانت مكتوبة في الورقة هو تغيير الانماط المجتمعية والسلوكيات السلبية علشان نشجع اكتر افراد ان هم يسافروا ويتحركوا لاغراض مختلفة. فكان أول تعليق لينا على كده إن إحنا التعامل مع المجتمع بيتطلب في أوقات كتير إن إحنا نغير التقاليد بطرق تقليدية وطرق يقبلها المجتمع علشان ما نبقاش بنواجههم بحاجة تضايقهم أو تخليهم ما يشاركوش معنا يعني. على الناحية الثانية اتنقلنا بالأكتر للكلام عن التوصيات اللي ممكن نعملها, وكانت أول ملاحظة خدناها ان اكتر الحاجات مكتوب تعمل الحكومات على كذا, تعمل الحكومات, بس كان بالاساس انه تعمل الحكومات والمجتمع المدني والقطاع الخاص والهيئات المعنية على اتخاذ القرار, ما تبقاش الحكومات بس هي اللي بتعمل عليه. من فاول الحاجات اللي ابتدينا نفكر فيها هو ازاي ان الحكومة, ان المجتمع المدني يشتغل مع الحكومة على تطوير برامج تعليمية معينة بحيث ان فكرة السفر تكون جزء اساسي من التعليم الرسمي. وكنا بنقترح ان يبقى في عندنا يعني زي رحلة اسبوعية او حاجة دورية بتحصل للاولاد في المدارس وللشباب ان هم يروحوا يكتشفوا, يبقى نوع من التجوال الداخلي جوه البلد بحيث ان تتنقل لهم الثقافة ديت, وان هم كمان يعملوا عمل مجتمعي في الاماكن المختلفة اللي بيروحوها. كمان ان احنا في زمان كنا نسمع عن نشاط الكشافة دوت, ما بقاش حي في المدارس بتاعتنا بشكل كبير, ازاي ان احنا نقدر نحييه مرة اخرى. الحاجة الثانية لما بنتكلم على تقليل الفجوات ما بين الناس وما بين فكرة السفر, وان احنا بنشجع اكتر سواء سفر المرأة او الفئات المختلفة ان هي تسافر, فكنا بنتكلم على استخدام الفن في الترويج للفكرة دي والشخصيات العامة, والشخصيات العامة مش انها تنزل اماكن مختلفة معاها الكاميرات علشان الناس تصورهم وهم رايحين بيروجوا لدوت, لا بينزلوا بشكل انساني وبيتكلموا مع الناس او بنعمل ورش عمل او احنا كمان مسؤوليتنا كافراد عارفين قد ايه السفر مهم ان احنا ننقل نموذج بديل للتعلم من خلال ان احنا اصلا بنتنقل وبنشتغل مع الناس. كمان كان في الحاجز الاقتصادي, احنا اكتر كنا بنتكلم على حاجات نقدر ان احنا نعملها بايدينا مش مجرد توصيات عامة. كان في تجربة بعتقد كانت في عمان, وكان صندوق محطوط في كوفي شوب والناس بتدخل بتتبرع بيه للشباب ان هم يسافروا من حتة لحتة. اشتغلنا في مصر بس دي للأسف ما قدرناش ان احنا نكملها, ما اشتغلناش عليها كويس يعني, ان يبقى في زي جمعية شهرية لو مجموعة صحاب بيدفعوا شير شهري وواحد بيسافر كل شهر او كذا سواء جوه البلد او برا البلد. الحاجة التالتة عن أهمية الشراكات اللي القطاع الخاص والمجتمع المدني محتاج يعملهم مع الحكومة, لأن في أوقات كتير يعني أنا بذكر أن من مصر بعد الثورة كان في تمويل جاي $70,000 بس لتذاكر السفر شباب من الوطن العربي ييجوا مصر يحضروا كامب معسكر. فالبلاد العربية المختلفة ما شجعتش اي حد ان هو يجي بالرغم من ان التمويل موجود, لان مصر بقت مكان خطر بعد الثورة يعني بقى فيه خوف من الامتداد الثوري لبلاد تانية. الحكومات في اوقات كتير لما بنكون بنتعامل معاها هي ما بتملكش شبكة واسعة تقدر ان هي تروح سواء للاطراف في بلدانها او ان هي تنتقل لشبكات شبابية مختلفة عن اللي هي بتتعامل معاها عن الحزب الحاكم او كذا. ففي اهمية ان يحصل دايما شراكة ما بين المجتمع المدني والحكومة بحيث ان الحكومة بتوصل للشبكة بتاعتها والمجتمع المدني بيوصل للشبكة بتاعته, وبيكون في تنسيق افضل بيضمن في فرص اكتر بتوصل للشباب. لما جينا نفكر في المعنيون بتغيير ثقافة السفر أو بنشر ثقافة التجوال فكرنا أن احنا محتاجين نخاطب الأحزاب لأن على سبيل المثال مثلا في مصر حزب الحرية والعدالة مسيطر على وزارة الشباب فوزارة الشباب ديت حاجة فاعلة جدا أن احنا نوصل بيها للشباب ونروج عندهم فمحتاجين نوصل للأحزاب للقبائل للتكتلات الدينية المختلفة اللي ممكن تدعم حاجة زي كده الكويك وينز والحاجات اللي احنا ممكن نعملها بشكل سريع نحن نعمل حملة تكون بتروج للسفر ممكن يبقى فيه يوم لسفر المرأة يوم لسفر الرجل سواء تدوينات سواء قصص سواء ورش عمل بتتعمل أو أن الناس بتشارك تجاربها المختلفة نحن نفعل بيوت سفر احنا عارفين أن دوت جزء من برنامج سفر بس أن احنا نفعله أكتر وأن يكون فيه أسر مضيفة بنضمن الأمان والسلامة للناس اللي بتسافر وبتتحرك أن هم يستقروا عندهم كمان فكرة التجوال الداخلي من خلال صناديق سفر المحلية ان احنا نشجعه بشكل عام او نتكلم على ازاي يتطور وكمان من خلال رحلات المدارس والكشافة اللي احنا محتاجين ان احنا نفعلها مرة تانية اننا نشجع ده برضو سفر بتعمله بس ازاي ان هو يتعمل على اطار اوسع اننا نشجع ان يبقى فيه منتجات بتخرج من تجارب التجوال المختلفة سواء كانت افلام او كتب او يعني ايا كان الشكل اللي بيخرج منه دوت بحيث ان هي تنتشر بالنسبة للناس التانية ويعرفوا اكتر عنها واننا نشجع التشبيك الفني في السفر سواء من خلال ان كتاب يقعدوا مع بعض او كاتب يتعلم من موسيقي او كذا وان برضو دوت يبقى له منتج بيثري الطرفين في عمله بس
في حدا عنده اي بس حسيته رح نظبط ونضيف المعنيون او اصحاب العلاقه ورح نقعد بعد الغداء عشان بس في كم نقطه بس قول عشان هلا بدا الغداء تفضلوا هلا تالا شكرا جدا جدا جلسه اعتقد انه انا استمتعت فيها وراح احتاج خلال هالساعتين انه احكي مع كم من حدا فيكم عشان اتاكد انه لما بدنا نعدل صح لانه هلا معنا بس 3-4 ساعات نعدل فما تختفوا من المكان وشكرا جدا
شكرا رامي وشكرا للجميع